good reviews in the New York Times.
Right, sure.
Wait a minute, how often does that happen?
I don't know.
Not that Jake gets a good review, but whenever they get a little bit of this from the
table.
Oh,
payola.
Yep.
This is Pete and Paul Explain It All.
It started already. Here it is. It's
already in progress, Jake.
Right.
Nice. Yeah. Connections like that, they're going to be happening all night.
We hope not.
How's about, should we tell them what we do?
Yeah, let's do that.
Just for those of you who haven't seen it, because we haven't done this.
Who hasn't seen the show before?
We haven't done it in 6 months, and it's going to be new to us, too.
So you don't know if we do it or not.
Well, when was the last time we did the show?
I don't know. Last year.
Last year.
2004.
We're going to give it up for 2004.
At least a while.
Well, let's get going.
Okay.
This is what we do. We get a suggestion from you. Something you want to talk about, something you want to know more about, whatever.
Something you wish you knew a little
more
about.
I was trying to hedge it.
I know.
Anyway, so we find that out, we talk about it.
Yeah.
We kind of go off on it a little bit, kind of ramble a little stories, and then we stop.
Yeah.
And then we set up some locations on the stage here of different things that we thought up for the monologue. And then we play those scenes, and then we follow those scenes forward or backward in time.
Yeah.
And then we keep going until the lights stop.
Yep.
And then when the lights go out, we get up and we're like, I can't believe it's over already.
Damn it, Sunday.
So that's just kind of an idea of what might be happening.
Let me sneak out the back.
Sneak out the back. I usually do go outside.
Yeah.
And get my car parts polished.
I do that too. Something you wish you knew a little bit more about. Something you wish you knew a little bit more about. It could be
your it's body.
Oh, yes.
Wow!
What is it?
Human body.
Crikey!
I just hear that.
Knitting.
I hear clearly. I know. I just want to say, I know a lot of people said a lot of stuff, but knitting was the only first one I heard clearly, right?
Yeah.
Knitting is.
Yeah.
For sure. Fine. Thank you. I just want to make sure we're not.
Yeah, it's gotta be fair.
Because, I mean, it's only coincidental that we wrote a lot of knitting stuff in this week.
Right. You might pull out some, thing, purling and whatever. Knit, purl,
Knitting.
I think is where you, this is just what I think.
Yeah, it's
it. You have the two needles.
Yep.
And the needles do a little knot.
All right, so I don't fucking know.
It's true, right? And it also, number one, is it's become very hot.
Has it?
Knitting is actually, it's pretty big, right?
Yes.
It is.
Yeah. People walk around and they got these little knitting purses.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
If you really don't like auditions, they're like...
They do. And it's a big canister where they can stick their yarn.
Sure.
And then through the, there's like a little hole.
Right.
Like they just might be knitting as a
rock. It looks like a giant bullet, doesn't it?
What's that?
Doesn't the canister look like a bullet?
Yeah.
My mom used to have those back in the 70s.
Like, oh,
really? And now everything old is new again. Yeah. My mom also used to be involved in macrame.
Oh.
Which is kind of like knitting, but the the thing is like a heavier gauge. It's like rope now, and not instead of like yarn.
But macrame is for the ponchos.
No. You could macrame a poncho, but it would be like wearing a cardboard box. Macrame is like if you tie knots, you can make like a hanging table.
Oh, hanging table. The rug kind of thing, and then you pull them through.
That's latch hooking.
Okay, we're getting it cleared up.
That's latch hooking.
Latch hooking, and then there's needle point.
Yeah.
My mom used to do the needle point.
That was the needle, yeah.
And so latch hooking is one that's like, I always thought it was like a rug.
Yeah.
You make a little design.
Usually, yeah, latch hooking.
But now macrame, to me, always reminded me of those things that look like kites that everybody always had.
Like a god's eye.
Yeah. What is that?
That's I think that's a derivation of like an American Indian sort of handy.
Something you do in camp.
Yeah, something you do in camp. Anything involved with the popsicle sticks is pretty much like a camp. hand back to me.
All right, fair enough. But that's so your mom does a lot of macrame.
My mom used to do all the crafts. She did you know, all the ones you've heard of, like crocheting and knitting and macrame. But she also did a lot of ones you haven't heard of, like crewel, which are kind of young children don't treat your kids. It's kind of like that, but it has to do with knots. And she did also something called candle wicking. She did something called quilling. She like literally, my mom was like, I don't know, she's like, remember like the obscure craft of the month club. If some guy in some cave in some remote area was doing it, my mom caught on. So I have to get these reeds from Pompeii, and we just, and then you make a knot out of it, and that's it, and you give it as a gift. I'm like, what are you talking about?
You know what I love? I love when the people, they get the crafts, but then they use the crafts from the ancient times, or from the Revolutionary War, and then they like set up a camp. Have you ever been to one of those things? You go to like the Reagan Library?
Sure.
Well, whatever,
or like Historical Williamsburg.
Yes.
Yeah.
Now, that's
like, that's like the game. That's the show.
Sure. You paid to Williamsburg, you had. But the, I went to the Reagan Library, and they had a whole encampment of like British soldiers and revolutionaries, and then they were like, they were trying to intern people in the British Army and grab you by the arm and come here, young lad. And that was like their English accent. That's come here, my boy.
That to me, that's like a, that's kind of like a sort of a half in, half out Renaissance festival.
Yeah.
We're kind of back in time, but not to an exciting time.
But then they'll like melt down their nuts or walls or whatever to make a cannon.
Wait a minute! What happened to the Reagan Library?
Wow!
Yeah. Oh man, Reagan had it going on. Why are the British soldiers outside the Reagan Library? Are they implying that Reagan was like in the civil,
the Revolutionary
War? Really?
He was a red pill.
And we elected him president after all of that?
But that's how old he was.
Yes.
No, it's true, but they just had that. That was one of the things they had at the Reagan Library. Do you know that they're going to build Air Force One at the Reagan Library? They're going to get an actual 747, or maybe it was a 727, and they're going to build it as part of the wing of the Reagan Library.
Really?
And you can walk right through and join.
You can do that in at Graceland.
Yeah.
It's another ticket. You have to buy an additional ticket. So you go to like the car museum, and then you get to go on the plane. The Lisa Marie.
You know, I actually went down to Nashville, and we were gonna go to Graceland, but it got canceled at the last minute.
Graceland got canceled.
No, we went down there. We didn't get to go.
It's too bad. When you go there, it's like it's kind of like the United Nations, because you seriously go to Graceland and there's people from around the world at Graceland. Like there's Japanese and German and Swedish and that's the world, right? Pretty much that's it. And they're all there. But it's just like people from around the world like trying to buy like Love Me Tender, like look at these Love Me Tender t-shirts. they want to sort of get their things stamped, like return to sender from like Heartbreak.
Okay.
Post office there.
Right.
The thing is, like, it's.
What's the one thing? What's the one thing that caught your attention when you were there? Besides me.
I would say the interior decorating scheme of Graceland itself is out of control. There's the jungle room, which is like a jungle. And I mean a jungle including a waterfall. But instead of grass, it's like deep-piled green shag. There's a room that's literally upholstered. They've upholstered the entire room. The walls, the ceiling, all in the same fabric. And there's a pool table in there, I think. And then there's like TVs, like an old like 50s-style TVs in there.
When we were down there, we got close. We didn't get to Graceland, but we went to like the Elvis Museum. And the one thing that stuck with me was TCB. Taking care of him.
That's his motto. I
love that.
The other thing that stuck with me
is the lightning bolt.
TCB. The other thing that stuck with me about Elvis, this is one of my favorite Elvis stories, is that Elvis, like I have a whole bunch of stories in my pocket. This one about Elvis is, Elvis was such a smooth talker. that he went to the White House and convinced the Secret Service to let him into the Oval Office to talk to President Nixon while he was carrying two fucking guns in his belt. And he just went and talked to Nixon, and there's a picture of him in, like, in his jumpsuit, and Nixon shaking hands as Nixon gives him a badge to become like an like a undercover, like honorary drug agent.
Probably came in handy.
Very handy. That's still because he knows where the drugs are, mostly at his house.
Then he went and talked to Priscilla's parents. How old was she? She was like 16 or
something. Yes, she was very young. He was in the Army, so it was all...
He's in the Army. Well, when he's in the Army.
Well, if you're in the Army, you're 18 in the Army, you can drink. Because you have an Army ID. Who's going to stop you? And you got a gun, I guess, in the Army.
Right here is a counter. It's a counter, and there's little pinch pots, and there's different types of glazes, and there's a spinning wheel right here.
And sitting at the spinning wheel is an old woman. She's like the kind of woman you expect to be sitting at a spinning wheel, sort of blousy, sort of like what, like big skirts, and then like a poncho as well, but rolled up in clay here, and then white, beautiful white hair pulled back in sort of a loose ponytail, and like hippie beads, this sort of thing.
And then right over here is a younger woman. She's probably in her 30s. And she's very hip and today. She's definitely got all the accoutrements. She's got Prada shoes, and she's got some sort of hip bag hanging off of her arm. And she's got a cell phone that's actually just hanging and dangling down into her pocket. And she's very attractive, and she's got tiny, tiny glasses. You know, like the really super, super hip ones that are almost just pointed. And she's in her lap, she's got a big book, the big book of pottery.
And then over here is an army barracks. It's an army barracks, and sort of like there's bunks and stuff over there. And here's just like a couple of army issue chairs. And once there's a young soldier, in the Army they call it the CFS, the chair for sitting. And you can young soldier there polishing his boots,
and he's just got a white white beater T-shirt on, and he's got his the fatigues on, he's got his boots, and he's got one boot in his hand. He's polishing it up,
and then over here at the door of the barracks is a young woman. And she's in a dress, and she has a suitcase with her, and it looks like she's got a dust cover. She's looking like she's been traveling a very long way to get here.
And then over here is a small area. It's a small room, and it's got a one chair, and it's actually a telephone booth, and the telephone booth is right here, and there's a young man in there. And he's got nice clothes on. You know, he's got wearing a nice suit, and he doesn't have any change.
Then outside is a sort of really well dressed guy. He's got a paper tucked under his arm. Keeps looking at his watch, and he is older, and he's got like big sort of round glasses, like John Lennon would wear. Finally, back here in this area is a huge window is what this is right here, and this looks into a like a nursery, like in a hospital, you know, and all the babies are under these little blankets, you know, sort of like mass production style.
And right here is a young man. He's probably in his 40s. He's got a mustache.
That's yummy, enough.
He's got a big hoop earring, and he's got like a little satchel over his shoulder, but he's got a bag, and he's wearing like moccasins.
And then over here is a doctor, cut from basically, if you look up encyclopedia, you'd like cut out this guy, like duh, yeah, and square jaw, but not smoking in the hospital. Exactly. Just the guy who wants to operate on you.
Happy day.
Yeah, totally happy day.
Congratulations.
Thank you. Listen, I don't want to start labeling the child like way ahead of time, man, but which one of these is mine?
Actually,
I mean, I suppose we could let the child choose for itself, right, man? That would be cool.
That would be, as you say, cool, right? But actually, they haven't brought in your child yet.
Oh, that's cool too, man.
He's in an incubator.
Right on.
He was premature.
Right on, man. I like that. You know what? It's nature. It doesn't go by our schedule. Man is a slave of nature, not the other way around. Like the ancient Egyptians made their calendar according to the flooding of the Nile, not the flooding of the Nile according to their calendar, right? Am I right here?
Your eyes are sort of rolling around in your head.
is this one mine, man?
Yes, that's yours there.
Well, that's cool, and I'm going to take him out of his little box there and let me see what he does.
God.
here you are.
Tony, here we are. Yes, really.
Wow, that's great.
You enlisted real quick.
Come on.
Tony,
I felt the patriotic call.
You. Oh, I don't doubt it. Look, I'm here. I need to bunk.
I live in an army.
Well, I'm sure they've got an extra spot.
That's, all the bunks are kind of spoken to. I don't mean to,
Don't give me Kozlowskis or something. Just don't take anything. Is there a Kozlowski?
Yes.
No. I figured there was.
What's going to need his bunk?
He's on KP. He's peeling potatoes all day long.
Back out. Get some rack time.
I just need a place to lie down. So for now, you got my book.
But
if the Sarge comes in, you're lost.
I'm lost?
You're lost. You wandered in here sort of like Goldilocks style. And... I don't think this is going to work.
Listen, I want this to work, but I just... But the army...
I know. We got married, we have to have a reception, we have to have a honeymoon, we have to finish basic training.
I know what.
Yeah.
It's only been a week, but it's going good.
Like number two in assembly or right. Oh, honey, I'm so proud.
Thank you. Goddamn spuds.
Hey, Kozlowski, what's up?
Nothing.
This is Megan.
Wow. Hi. Hi, yourself.
She's a friend of mine.
A friend? I think I'm more than a friend.
Well, I mean a good acquaintance. I mean, this is my,
fiance, is that what you're trying to say?
Yes.
Wow, fiance, I've been peeling potatoes. What kind of thing would you do?
Son for so long.
I would just,
Mom, don't cry.
I can't help it.
Please.
I see your future crumbling.
It's not crumbling. It's just I'm stepping out on my own. I'm trying to.
I know. I think you're stepping out onto a stone bridge that's crumbling. You're gonna fall into the abyss of your dark future.
Wow, I'm really looking forward to getting back home.
I cooked your favorite, but I cooked the low-fat version because you're getting a little rounder on the middle.
Low-fat lasagna?
Yes. Veggie, low-fat lasagna with whole wheat pasta because it's lower carbs because the fiber, you need to subtract the fiber.
Like my mom's name.
Mom's awful.
Yeah.